really a deep ingrained sense of ignorance about their true reality, their true essence. You know, light, energy cannot be destroyed. You cannot kill energy. You cannot. You may damage and hurt and kill our outer layer of biology, but our spirit lives on, moves on. So, it is something. It to me, it's a little bit like, you know, going around in circles. Why would we worry about death when death is nothing but a transition into another state? You know, but again, that is a cultural default where we are taught about these things, you know, and also we do get attached, you know. Last year I lost my best friend, my Hindu best friend, and I felt such grieving, such need for grieving, and I cried for 2 good weeks, you know, because that's how we are. Are you there? Hello?
The worst I feel, the less you breathe life into my body. Hi, everyone. This is Seth at BBS Radio. We're having a little difficulty with the lines. We'll try to get the show back on track just as soon as possible.
Interesting little break we had from Spirit, just so that the audience knows, there were some line difficulties, probably something to do with something or other. And when we left off, you were about to quote something by Richard Bach. Would you want to pick up there? Or do you...
Oh, really?
Yes. Or shall we just start all over?
No, I can quote that because your question was so pertinent about the fear, you know, upon which we are so
focused,
fed. Yes, and this is one of my. I actually found it properly, and I will read it to you now properly from my little booklet that I carry with me all the time. And Richard Bach, in his famous book Illusion, says, "The mark of your ignorance is the depth of your belief in injustice and in tragedy. What the caterpillar calls the end of the world, the master calls a butterfly." That's just about defines, you know, the different level of ignorance on our planet. You know, you still have people whose life is to point out to somebody and shifting the responsibility of their creations onto somebody else and on their life instead of, you know, applying the famous principle where you point to your index, three other fingers point down at you, you know.
Right.
And so we live in that mixed pot where it is always easier to distract oneself with things and people and events outside yourself instead of working with, you know, within. Those that work within have no such worries about anything like that, you know. Really.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I couldn't agree with you more. And it's a very interesting process, and it just seems to be an ongoing process. And some days I notice I have more success at it than others. I think it was in one of your books that I just read where you said something about staying in the core And wherever you go out there, you are within the you're still within your core. Was that something that you wrote about?
You know, very often I don't actually know what I write because I am a student of my own books, as you know. People always think I'm a nut, and I say it, you know. They really question my mental integrity when I say that I study my own books. But the fact is, I do, and because they are coming from such a hard place that my human self would need to study and to go dive deep into it. And in fact, that is a truth that if you remain centered in your heart and connected to your core, you never forget in the moments of difficulty that you are love, that you are peace. And when you walk around and when you relate around and when you travel around knowing that, nothing or anyone can take you out of that peace, not very long anyway, you know, because you're still human. So some people will try and for a while succeed, but when you have disciplined yourself about going back to core, to the essence of who you are, you know, nothing matters, no one matters. And you really live by, I certainly live by the principle that anything, anyone, any event only has the importance that I choose to give them, and no further.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, if it starts to upset me, I use my mantra, you have no power, you have no power. And I go back to my center, you know.
Yeah, right. You're able to communicate, too, with some of the ascended masters, and on those levels, everything is a matter of love and light, isn't it?
Yes, it is, and you cannot go into those dimensional levels without absolute surrender and without an absolute knowing that you too are of the same light as the masters and the gods and the ascended masters and the angels and the archangels. There is absolutely no separation between our light and their light. All we have to do is purify our minds and our hearts enough in order to be able to reach those higher levels of energy, and also to be given their attention, because, you know, it works both ways. They have to lower their energy frequencies in order to interact with ours, and we have to raise ours in order to interact with them. So I'm sure we must meet in some intermediate dimension where we go as far as we can go and they come as low as they can come, so to speak, you know?
Yes, right. That makes a lot of sense. That really does. We have to kind of clear away the debris so that we can reach up. I guess, suppose we come out of our crown chakra, if you want to get technical, and they come down and lower their themselves into a lower dimension to meet us. And
bit like, you know, going around in circles. Why would we worry about death when death is nothing but a transition into another state, you know? But again, that is a cultural default where we are taught about these things, you know, and also we do get attached, you know. Last year I lost my best friend, my Hindu best friend. And I felt such grieving, such need for grieving, and I cried for 2 good weeks, you know, because that's how we are. Are you there? Hello?
really a deep ingrained sense of ignorance about their true reality, their true essence. Light, energy cannot be destroyed. You cannot kill energy. You cannot. You may damage and hurt and kill our outer layer of biology, but our spirit lives on, moves on. So, it is something.